In this segment of the Microsoft Word tutorial for Mac, I'm going to go over the basics of the Word application, identifying some of the key elements of the Word interface, and highlight some of the differences between Word for Windows and Mac. To open Word, go to Launchpad and locate the Word application, or by simply typing Word on the search box. In my case, I'm using Microsoft Word for Microsoft 365, the latest version as of the time of this recording. When you first open Word, you'll notice that on the top there is this menu, and this is the typical menu on a Mac OS system. We have Word, and this is where you set up the preferences. Then File, Edit, View, Insert, Format, and so on. The rest is laid out in tabs. The Home tab with all the options on the right-hand side, the New tab to start new things, such as a new document, or to use a template from the existing repository of Word. Recent, this includes recent documents. Shared, these will be documents that have been shared with you. And open, this is to open documents, whether from recent folders or from OneDrive or from the Mac system. We can either start the new document directly from the Home tab and click on Blank Document, or we can go here to New and select Blank Document. You can use one of the templates from here as well. And it's a matter of just clicking to open it and then filling in the information. For now, we are going to start with a blank document. Click on Blank Document, double-click, and that will open the Microsoft Word application with a blank document and ready to type. Before we start creating our first document, we are going to go over some of the elements in Microsoft Word here for Mac OS. At this point, Microsoft Word, it's not in full screen. We could put this in full screen and it will look something like this. And the menus will show up on the very top. On the very top, as I mentioned earlier, you have the menu system from the Mac OS. And these are the options for Microsoft Word. Below, we have the Home tab, what's referred to as the Office ribbon. The Office ribbon typically includes a set of icons, or actually groupings of icons, the font section of icons and commands for managing formatting in a document, styles, and so on. Typically, each section is part of one of those tabs. So you have the Home tab, then the Insert tab, Draw, Design, Layout, References, Mailings, and so on. Typically, these are organized in the order that you develop the document. You'd start writing in here, creating a document, and use basic formatting tools. Then, as you develop your document further, then you go ahead and insert components such as pictures, shapes, icons, 3D models, and so on. Then you can change the design of the document to make it look consistent and change the layout of it, then use references and so on. One thing that might be different from Microsoft Word for Windows is that the menu options here differ from that of Windows, but the Office ribbon is mostly consistent with Windows. For better understanding of using Microsoft Word, I do suggest that you start getting used to using those tabs from the ribbon instead of the menus on the top, because the menus will be very different from that in Windows. Then on the bottom left, we have the number of pages for the document, then the number of words in the document, and accessibility checking. That's important nowadays. And then over here on the right-hand side, we have the different views. Further to the right-hand side, we have the option to zoom in and out. On the top right, this is the quick search option. If you don't know where something is, For example, if you want to know how to insert a footer, you can simply search on the top right and it will take you directly to that command, and you don't have to know where it is located. You can do the same thing with, let's say, page numbers. Further down here, we have commenting and editing permissions and the sharing options as you collaborate with other individuals. So that's the general interface. Next, we are going to move into creating our first document and some of the key concepts related to formatting in Microsoft Word. I know this is a very basic, but hang in there or forward to the next section in this tutorial if this is too basic for you.